I'm going to demonstrate now a technique using my old faithful brush. This is one that I've mutilated. I rounded it off. It's stiff. It's an old oil painting brush. And to make trees, and it takes a bit of practice, obviously. You could do this on plain old paper rather than using watercolor paper for it, just to get the technique down to begin with. So I'm going to drag this down. And drag this down here. I'm not going to worry about the little speck that went that way. And here I'm dragging this outwards. I'm holding the brush vertically, you will see. And you can see how that forms what looks like a spruce tree. If you're doing trees in the distance, use the same type of brush, and you're dragging them. What I will do is I will put water at the base so that when I'm starting, I'm not starting on dry paper. I'm starting onto paper that has some water in it, and this will create the fog effect as well. And then I might switch over and put some pretty brown. We could make it a little bluer, darker, and then put some dabs of paint and it will come up looking like foliage. If I didn't do that into wet, what I would have is I would have all of this starting at the base. So what I have to do, rather than have all those lines, is to go in immediately and try to erase them. But it's hard. You can see that unless you really get in there and scrub right away, this is a much better effect. Paint from the wet water. So now we have two different types of spruce trees. Those that you're painting in the distance. I'm gonna do it like this, using the side of the brush and lifting up, take off like an airplane, and you'll see the tops actually form like that. And then you can come and do this little bit with the side of the brush like that, and it looks like spruce trees in a distance. Or you can just use this brush making the vertical trees back and forth, but make sure that your brush is one of these that's been used for a while. An oil painting brush has got a stiffer bristle. If you use a soft one, you're not going to get the same kind of definition of the trees. Now, some people like that. Some people make that a style, but you would take a fair amount of experience even to get that. But you don't have the openings that you do with a fan brush that's meant for actually for oil paintings. Other things to consider when you're doing trees, let's grab another one here, is the use of a trailing brush. Here's a trailing brush. It's got a long bottom to it. So what I'm going to do, if you're doing a dead tree, is I'm going to start from the bottom. I'm going to go up, and I'm making it so that it's got some shape and character to it. You don't want to become too, quote, swoopy. You don't want to make your trees so that they put some character into them. Okay, so we're making dead trees now, but we can make these come a little more to life because it could be a winter tree, deciduous tree that's lost its foliage for the winter. However, if you wanted to make it into a more of a summer tree, dampen a sea sponge. You buy these at the art supply stores or highfalutin bath shops, I guess, maybe. But dampen the sea sponge and then tap it into your pigment and use a test paper, which I've used the back of this, to see what kind of a pattern is going to be coming. Make sure you haven't got a big glob there that's going to be an issue. So I dampen the sponge And I apply it to the branches to make it look as though I've spent all afternoon putting leaves on the branches. But I've twisted it and turned it, and now I've got all my leaves on there. I let it dry for a bit, do it a second time. It adds more three-dimensional aspect to it. I should let it dry even a little longer. You can do that in conjunction with a fan brush. Here's my old fan brush again. You can do that in conjunction with the fan brush just by pressing it down on its side. You just have to tie it together. Maybe towards the center of the tree, you're going to have a little thicker foliage. So you're building it up like that. Another thing you can use to make leaves on trees is cellophane. The kind that crackles. You can hear that when you're using it. Don't use, for example, saran wrap because it's all pretty soft and it won't have the same effect as the crinkly type of plastic like this. So again, I'm just using that, pressing it down. Just to demonstrate here, you can create foliage using it. And if it's not, just do this on a separate sheet of paper so you can control what's going to happen there. And then you can actually come in later on if you want and add some branches to make it look as though, you know, they're shrubs or something like that. Just break them up like that. Then I come back with my favorite brush and I put in something to tie this all together. Because otherwise it will look just like a lobby mess here. So you're doing a combination of things that will build it up to make it look like a forest. Now I'm going to bring in some yellow to mix in with the and you can build it up so that I don't want to make it look as though it's snowing blue, so we're going to fix that by remembering, they say this is a mountainside, we're going to build up the whole thing. And you'll have some life in there. I mean by life, it's we're going to make it really dark here. So you've got some contrast. And see how this yellow will expand. If you use bismuth yellow, which is more spreadable, of course, anyways, it will spread more and make more like leaves because it's got some white paint in it. It will look more like foliage. So that's one approach to making leaves on trees. Now this is dried a little bit more. I can come in and put in some of the lighter colors. Generally speaking, however, with watercolors, you paint from light to dark, and with oils, you paint from dark to light. So try to keep that in mind. Location of a light source is always important. So just to demonstrate, if you're going to make some kind of a foreground here, now this is not meant to be a picture at all. It's just showing you some of the techniques. If you did have this, you would have a shadow coming off maybe there, not straight, but to go with the landscape, it would be bent. And then also you would have some more darkening there because of the top of the trees making it darker. So you sort of keep that whole thing in mind.